All right, guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we are going to talk about rod knock. So this is something that I wasn't actually planning on talking about, or I didn't think I would have to discuss, but there's kind of an elephant in the room now. So for those of you that don't know, a very popular YouTuber recently had rod knock in his 340i. They basically put a Flomax turbo on his car, a bunch of supporting mods for fueling and things like that. And when they were getting ready to tune it, they actually turned the car on and it was knocking. So, of course, that sparked a lot of questions. And people were asking me, does the B58 have a rod knock issue? Does the Flomax turbo cause rod knock? And things like that. And just from the questions that people were asking, it kind of told me that a lot of people weren't really informed on what rod knock is and what causes it. So I'm going to go ahead and use this opportunity to explain that to you guys. So hopefully it'll help put your mind at ease a little bit. And then also we can speculate a little about what could have potentially caused the rod knock issue in Thickwhip's 340i. Now I'm gonna preface this by saying I don't know John, I don't work with CES Motorsports, I don't know anything about the history of his 340i, so all we can do is kind of guess. And honestly, at this point, he's given a little bit of information about what he thinks it could have been, but with these kind of problems, you don't know until you tear the engine down. So it's not really his fault that he doesn't have a lot of the information, but I'm hoping that this video can kind of give you guys a little more, and then we can use that understanding to guess what could have potentially caused his issue. So first things first, the question I get a lot is, does the Flomax turbo cause rod knock? And the answer is absolutely not. Again, if you understand what rod knock is, then you'll understand that that question doesn't really, make sense because the two aren't really correlated. Now, the second question that I get a lot is, does the B58 have a rod knock issue? And again, the answer is no. This isn't something that's common or frankly that I've even heard of before this actual instance, but it's something that can happen to any engine. So in order to explain it, I think it's best to shift gears to a BMW engine that does have a common rod knock issue. And that engine is from the E90 and E92 M3. So the S65 that's in those generation M3s is very well known and documented to have rod bearing issues. And this is something that you'll hear about a lot. If you buy a car, the first thing you should do is drop the oil pan, pull the rod bearings, and swap them out. Because if you don't have a really good service history and understanding of how that car's been treated, it's basically like a ticking time bomb. And it's kind of funny because the issues that these cars have is directly correlated to kind of like the same reason why I recommend certain oil weights for our cars. And people don't understand why, but they understand that the S65 has a rod bearing issue. So when you're looking at your engine's assembly, you have three components that we're concerned about here. One is your crankshaft, and that's what actually rotates and drives the engine. Then you have the connecting rods that connects the crankshaft to the piston, and between those two components, you have a rod bearing. And that rod bearing is basically a semicircle on top and a semicircle on bottom that's between those two mating surfaces. And it's designed to basically take all of the wear between those components. So that is a little bit softer than the material on your connecting rod and on your crankshaft. And as it wears away, it can simply be replaced, and then you can continue driving your car without having to, completely replace your engine. Now, in most cases, this really shouldn't be wearing away, but it's just designed that way so that if there is any damage, you can kind of minimize the effect on the engine. But in the case of the S65, it's very well known that these rod bearings wear extremely quickly. Now, if you want to know the cause of that, it's very simply due to the rod bearing clearances compared to the recommended oil weight for that engine. So these S65s rev really high. They rev over 8,000 RPM and they're designed for the track. So when you're designing an engine to be in scenarios like that, you're going to basically create very large tolerances in the engine. And those very large tolerances allow everything to expand when they get hot. It's going to generate a lot of heat when you have the RPMs really high and you're running laps around a track and things like that. So everything can expand, but it won't actually contact each other and create that metal-to-metal friction that can damage your engine. So in order to do that safely, you have to run thicker oil. And that's why these older M3 engines are designed to run really heavy oil. I believe this S65 runs 10W60, so it's really, really heavy. Now, the only problem with that is, for whatever reason, the rod bearings were not designed to the right tolerance. And due to that tight tolerance, the oil struggles to lubricate those components effectively. So you basically have some metal-to-metal contact that over time wears away at those bearings and can eventually cause issues. Now, clearances have two primary responsibilities. Like I said, they have to be large enough for oil to get in between the passages, but they also have to be tight enough that there's no excess movement and unwanted directions. And when you have excessive rod bearing wear, you're going to get excessive movement between your connecting rod and your crank. So now there's basically too large of a gap where even if the oil is between there, the rod can move up and down. And when the rod is actually moving up and down on the crank and you can actually hear it, that metal to metal contact, that's the sound you hear that people call rod knock. So it's literally your connecting rod knocking back and forth on the crankshaft. So basically this all comes down to oil. That's the biggest cause for any excess rod bearing wear or any issues that could cause rod knock. If you don't have proper lubrication, you wear away at your bearings, you can spin your bearings and have a lot of different issues that basically drop oil pressure and cause rod knock. So again, this isn't something that's caused by accessories, you know, or components that you attach onto your engine. It's strictly related to the oiling. So this is a huge reason why I recommend that people don't just jump to a thicker oil than your engine is designed for. Just because your car is tuned or just because it's running a specific turbo or a specific amount of power doesn't change the tolerances inside of your engine. And so it's still important to run the correct weight oil because you still need to make sure that your oil is thin enough to properly lubricate your bearings, your cams, and everything else that's inside of your engine. So again, this just kind of reinforces that point. Don't just jump up to super heavy oil because your car is making more power. I have some guy in the comments on a lot of my videos that tells people they should at least run like 10W50 or something like that when they're tuning their cars. Absolutely don't do that. Just stick with the weight that your engine is designed for until you modify something in your engine internals that requires running a thicker oil. So now that we have a good understanding of what causes rod knock and what it is, we can talk about John's car. And he basically said two things in that video that kind of indicated what could have been a problem. So the first one was that they bought the car used and they did the car's first oil change right before installing the turbo. And a lot of people have basically speculated that the car was ragged on and potentially they put a thicker oil in the engine to try to hide the problem. So let's say that your engine is knocking, you know that the tolerance between your connecting rods and your crank is too big, and so you're trying to figure out what you can do to at least drive the car. What a lot of people do is run a thicker oil because that thicker oil will do a better job of filling up that clearance to prevent the connecting rods from actually bouncing back and forth. So it is something that some people do. You know, they'll run that 10W50 or 10W60 oil in an engine that's not designed for it so that it can kind of hide the noise that typically is associated with rod knock. So that's just a guess. Again, nobody knows the history of the car or the engine. Nobody has any good data on what oil was pulled from the car. I don't know if they did an oil analysis on it or anything like that. But that is something that I would definitely recommend if you're getting a used car, change the oil right away and just make sure that you have the right oil in there before you do any other modifications. Now, the other thing that was a little bit weird was the actual issue he had with the turbo. And what he said was when they first started the car, the turbo seemed to be seized. Now, if the turbo is seized, typically that's caused by improper oiling. So potentially there could have been an issue with how the car was primed when they installed the turbo. They didn't get oil flowing through it very well. Or there could have been an actual oil pressure issue, maybe like his oil pump or something like that was clogged that could have caused that issue. So again, depending on, you know, how the car was maintained previously, if it had metal already, you know, kind of traveling through all the oil passages and stuff like that, that could have gotten stuck in the oil passages of the turbo when they first turned it on, and that could have caused it to seize. Or maybe, like I said, if it was having an oil pump, oil pressure issue, that could have caused the turbo to seize and created some damage in the turbo that could, you know, travel throughout the rest of the engine and then eventually cause damage to the rod bearings. So a lot of different things can happen there. You know, again, this is all just speculation, but just suffice it to say that there was an oil issue that caused that engine to experience rod knock. So could have been oil pressure related, wrong oil weight, you know, just the car being ragged on previously, whatever the case may be, It most likely had some previous damage, but it could have really been anything. So yeah, I hope this explains Rodnok to you guys and helps put your mind at ease a little bit about the issue. If you just bought a Flowmax turbo, you don't have anything to worry about. Just make sure you're running the right oil, make sure you prime your turbo properly, and everything should be good to go. There are a lot of people running Flowmax turbos, other hybrids, and obviously other big turbo kits and not having this issue. So his is definitely unique and unfortunate, but hopefully he gets back on his feet soon. So thanks again for watching. I hope this video helps. And if you guys have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do do do.